Hello everyone, my name is Sultan Alneyadi and I'm an astronaut living and working on board the International Space Station. Today we are going to explore the differences between physical and chemical changes. There are many different chemical and physical changes happening on board the space station at a given time. Are you ready to explore the station with me? Let's get started. A physical change is when the molecules of a substance are rearranged while their composition remains the same. For example, if we take an ice cube and melt it, a physical change has occurred. The H2O molecules that make up the liquid water are the same H2O molecules that made up the solid ice cube. As solid ice, the H2O molecules are frozen in place and can only vibrate. Liquid water molecules are able to move and flow around each other. A chemical change occurs when a substance undergoes a change in its molecular composition, meaning that an entirely new substance is formed. Generally speaking, a chemical change cannot be easily reversed. There are six indicators that tell us a chemical change has occurred: the production of gas or bubbles, the production of light, the production of an odor, a permanent color change, the formation of precipitate or solid, and the change in temperature. Sometimes we refer to chemical changes as chemical reactions. For example, the rocket that brought me up to the International Space Station utilized a chemical reaction. The engines of the Falcon 9 rocket burn kerosene and liquid oxygen to generate enough thrust to propel us upwards out of Earth's atmosphere. Once ignited, the rocket's engines produce light, hot gas, and smoke that you can see billowing out of the bottom of the rocket. These all indicate that a chemical change is taking place. On station, the solid fuel ignition and extinction, growth and extinction limit, or SOFI gel investigation, studies burning in microgravity. These experiments will help to determine how fuel temperature affects material flammability. The result of this study will help us to better understand fire safety and suppression in space and on Earth. A good example of a physical change is when we add water to our dehydrated food in space, because this is totally reversible by removing the water. And once eaten, this is a chemical change because the acid in our stomachs breaks down the food and changes its chemical composition. Another example of a physical change is when we cut our hair in space. And this is a physical change because the composition of the hair has not changed. Once the hair is cut, it is still hair. There are no indications that a chemical change has occurred. Can you think of other examples of physical and chemical changes back on Earth? To learn more and experiment with physical and chemical changes, check out the corresponding classroom connection online. Thank you for exploring science with me today, and see you soon.